Dear students, today I am going to teach a poem named Amanda, which has been composed by Robin Kelling. This poem has been written related to the present scenario under which children consider themselves upset when they are instructed by their parents. Now in this poem it has been written, every child feels that he is controlled and instructed not to do one thing or another. It is the instruction given by the parents to the children what to do or not to do. And in that very phase, each and every child feels that his or her freedom is being curtailed. Naturally, they should not be treated like that, because when the parents suggest their children, they suggest for their bright future. They try their best to teach them better lesson regarding good manners, regarding etiquette, so that in the coming phase, the child could be better in his or her own life. But this poem has been started in commanding form, where Amanda is being commanded by her mother. Amanda is being instructed by her mother, and Amanda does not think herself well when she is commanded by her mother. She feels herself irritated just after observing the dominating attitude of her mother. But she listens each and everything stated by her mother. Now the poem starts. Don't bite your nails, Amanda. Here, Amanda is being instructed by her mother not to bite nails. Don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Not only this, she is being instructed by her mother not to keep her shoulders in hunching phase. Not only this, she asks her not to keep herself in slouching phase. She asks her to be in a straight phase, to sit properly, and to take each and every action in a good manner. In real sense, she is willing to teach her good manners. She is willing to teach her etiquette so that Amanda could be a good student, or Amanda could be a good child in her own life. Now, as the instructions given by her mother, Amanda does not feel herself well, rather she feels herself upset and irritated, as she doesn't think that instructions given by her mother will be useful in her future. So in second stanza, Amanda imagines herself in her imaginary world, where she finds herself away from the scolding face of her mother. There is a languid emerald sea. It is the imagination of Amanda, where she is imagining related to a languid emerald sea. Means the sea which is being imagined by Amanda is calm and composed, and the water of the sea has been compared along with precious stones emerald. It's metaphor here. Where the sole inhabitant is me, in that very languid emerald sea, in that very calm sea. She considers herself as the only inhabitant amidst the sea, a mermaid, and she compares herself with a mermaid. Mermaid stands for an imaginary sea creature having women's head and fish's tail instead of legs. So under her imaginary world, she considers herself amidst the sea like a mermaid, drifting blissfully, moving joyfully wherever she wants to move. So it is her imaginary phase where she is willing to remain in peaceful phase in order to enjoy her life. Now, in the third one, again, she is confronting her mother where she is being nagged, where she is being scolded again, where she is being instructed again. Did you finish homework, Amanda? Now she is again being questioned by her mother whether she had completed her homework or not. Did you tidy your room, Amanda? Not only this, she is again questioned whether she had kept each and everything in her room in a well manner or not. Not only this, whether she had cleaned her room or not. I thought I told you to clean your shoes, Amanda. Previously, Amanda had been suggested by her mother to clean her shoes. And again, she is being reminded by her mother whether she had cleaned her shoes or not. So under these kinds of instructive phase, she feels herself completely upset. She feels herself completely depressed. She feels herself in the phase of extreme depression. And under that very phase, she considers herself as an orphan. She is willing to be an orphan rather to be in the company of her mother. I am an orphan roaming the street. And she imagines herself that it would be better for her to be just like an orphan roaming in the streets, in the dusty street, where she would be in position to make different kinds of pattern by using her feet, where there would be no instructions given by her mother. Ultimately, it can be said that she is willing to remain independent whenever instructions are given by her mother. She feels herself that her freedom has been curtailed. She is not willing to accept each and everything under instruction, having positive attitude, having positive mindset. And under that very phase, in the third line of this stanza, this has been written, "The silence is golden, the freedom is fit." According to Amanda, she is willing to remain in silent phase, in peaceful phase, as she considers it, the silence is golden, the freedom is fit. Next, is the freedom is fit. Naturally, it's a human instinct to remain free. No one likes to be enslaved by anyone, and in real sense, no one is willing to be dominated by anyone. Rather, everyone wants to enjoy his or her own freedom. So having such kind of feelings in her mind, she says, "The silence is golden, the freedom is sweet." In the meantime, when she was feeling herself in the imaginary field, in the imaginary phase, considering herself completely alone, just like an orphan, where she was in position to evaluate the peaceful stage of silence, the enjoyable stage of freedom. She is being instructed by her mother, she is being questioned by her mother, she is being prohibited by her mother not to eat chocolate. Her mother prohibits her to eat chocolate due to acne on her face. Again, she finds herself under instructive phase by her mother, where she feels herself completely upset as she has been prohibited to eat chocolate due to acne over her face. Will you please look at me when I am speaking to you, Amanda? Now, it clearly indicates the phase of Amanda when she is being said something by her mother, what to do or not to do. In real sense, it's very clear that Amanda feels herself completely upset and does not pay proper attention towards the instruction given by her mother. It's why her mother utters, "Will you please look at me when I am speaking to you, Amanda?" वह अमांडा से कहती है कि क्या तुम मेरी तरफ देखोगी जब मैं तुमसे बात कर रही होती हूँ. Now, again, Amanda finds herself in her own imaginary world and considers herself as a Rapunzel. I am Rapunzel. I have not to care. Here, Rapunzel is a female character of a German fairy tale who had been captivated by a witch in a high tower. Rapunzel had a very long, beautiful golden hair by which the witch used to make contact whenever she wished to do so. Rapunzel, whom she would allow to climb on the tower by using long hair. Means Rapunzel, just after being captured by the witch, had been kept in a high tower where she was living alone and no one could come before her without her consent, except the witch by whom she had been captured, by whom she had been arrested. So, even being alone in tower, Rapunzel was enjoying herself, and Amanda, just after having imagination of a Rapunzel, feels herself like a Rapunzel and utters and addresses herself, "I am Rapunzel." She considers herself in the world of imagination as a Rapunzel. "I have not to care." And being a Rapunzel, she is not willing to care for anyone. She is not willing to listen to anyone which could be irritating one. She is not willing to be nagged by anyone, especially by